एवरीवन तो आर वी ऑल गुड टू गो नाउ। Okay, so let me share my screen. Okay. Now let me open my clips. Okay, everyone. So today we have a very special topic to start. Okay, and that is known as socket programming. Okay, which topic we're talking about? Socket programming. Socket programming, like as you know, like how we want to communicate. Okay. From front end to back end and vice versa. So that's through socket programming we would like to communicate. Okay, so let's get started and we'll start working with how the socket programming takes and how we pick it up. Well, I'm sharing with you one zip file with everyone. I want you to have it first, and then we can go ahead. Okay. Okay, so I'm sharing one file with all of you. Did you get this link? Yes, everyone, did you get this link? Okay, so please keep this file locally available. I'm going to create a new folder right here. The name called and broadly some of the folders to be get created. Okay, so I'm creating a new folder here and going inside this. And I need some new dependencies to get added. Okay, I'm saying npm space I space express space socket.io. At the rate specific version 1.3.7. Okay, two dependencies, express and socket. Check that. Awesome, permission required. But first of all, let me go back and create. New file, that package.json. We're gonna use sudo before. The dependencies are getting started. And there we go. We have got this dependencies ready with us. Okay, I request to kindly download these dependencies, and here at the same time I will be creating a new folder called public. Inside this I'll be creating a new file called okay index.html file, and the folders or the file which I've given to you, that js dot zip. Okay, that folder which is there, this I'll be keeping it in my local environment. Okay, so this JS I'll keep it under my public folder. There we go. So kindly make it ready and let me know by typing done in the chat window. Let me know everybody once you are done and the folder structure is ready for all. Friends, please help us if you're all ready. Okay, so if you're all ready, then we will start using the same Express. Okay, for our current development, few dependencies I've already downloaded. Now, here we'll be using some Express related part. Okay, so once again, sorry, to create a new file under our Rocket demo. Okay, and we also required then we need one more module that is called HTTP module or required. It is the inbuilt module of Node.js. Okay. Dot server and pass app as in parameter and use var io equal to require socket.io. Okay, and here we are passing what HTTP. Okay, then once it is done, then we'll be using app.use express.static public, and one more thing we'll be using, io.on, that is an event. Okay, we'll be using this option like in connection. It's a predefined event, remember this. And here we'll be writing a callback function and saying log thingy. And let's say always you can use so done, and after that I'll be saying node space, and you should see the message like this. Okay, so go ahead and make it happen and let us know. Tanisha for the update, waiting for the others. Please help us once you're ready. Okay, so it seems like it's ready. So we would like to go ahead and talk about our next. Our file is ready. Okay, and server.js is implemented. Now in our index.html file too. Okay, everybody, in our index.html file too, we have to inform few things. Like how we're going to use this socket part. So in our index.html file here, okay, I'll use this. Okay, first thing what I'll be doing it here is in my body, I would like to use a script tag, a script src equal to the first file which is available. Is called under the JS jQuery. Clear? And once again, socket. So these two dependencies we are taking it. And the first step I would like to use here that is called. A script, and within this script, I would like to use var socket equal to okay that we're writing it here. Okay, var socket equal to what IO. So once it is done, so it'll be going ahead and open which server port number it is in localhost 3000. We'll be saying localhost. You should see this message is available because user is connected via socket. Reason because in our index.html file, we're creating the object of socket.io with the help of this socket.io file. And you should see this message called user is connected via socket. Can you check and let me know? And even if I open it multiple times, number of clients I will open it up multiple time, I'm going to see this message. Can you check and confirm, please? Thanks, Ravindra, Tanisha, and Kalyappan. What about others? Please confirm. Great. It's working fine initially, and now sure, Pranali, server dot to use this. Please quickly help us if you all are ready, please. So if it is ready, we'll be going ahead with the next one now. So the next thing would be like, I can see the user is connected, okay? And I can also shift the dependency of this particular code in a separate file. So in JS, okay, folder, I'm gonna create a new file that is called app.js. Which one? App.js. Okay, from where I'll be including this into my code. So in my JS, create a new file, give the name called app.js. And app.js, I would like to write the code. Okay, that is called was socket equal to IO. Okay, and I'll be using socket, watch it, socket. Dot on here, I'm writing one message call. Connect. Okay, once it is connected, then what should happen here? I'm saying dot function. It is a predefined event called connect. Here we are using this log by saying connected to socket server. Because this message, if you're connected with your server, this message will be printed in your browser. Okay, let's see in my index.html file. I would not be using this script anymore. Instead, I can see app.js. Okay, everyone. So now, if I start my browser in inspect in a console, I should see this message go connect to the socket server. Can you see this right now here? This also, you can see connected to the socket. That means client and server both are receiving the same message. You can see here also. Can you check? And let me know, please. Okay, so you're able to see this message coming up of this socket. Okay, now if you want to stream the live data, everybody, if you want to stream the live data, now you would like to perform some more better activity now. And what's that? Let's take a look. So friends, here in the code, okay, everyone, here in the code, you really need something more active part. Okay, which I'm trying to give it to you now. Okay, what's that active part is? Let's take a look. So we have a call server.js and everything. And step number one here. Okay, we would like to get some more info here. And what the info is, let's see. So we're talking about require express HTTP, require HTTP server app, IO require socket.io. That's all we needed. Now, the next thing what I'm looking forward for is IO.on, that was the connection. And now, after this, I'll be writing one more event here called socket. Okay, that is once again a predefined event. And in this socket.on, I'm having what message. And here after that, we are having function. Okay, so in this function, we'll be writing what message. This we are writing socket.on message function method, and here we are writing log. In log, we are saying what we are saying message received. Okay, what are you saying? Message received. And what message we have to print? Here we are printing with plus keyword message dot text. Clear? And after receiving a message from the one particular client, we'll be further broadcasting to the other clients also. Like suppose one client has sent a message. I want to send a message to all other clients, like how in WhatsApp you see. In a group chat, somebody will send a message to where? To the group, so it get automatically broadcast to others. So we can use socket dot okay, socket dot broadcast at ML. Okay, here the first parameter will be message. Okay, and which message it is that you're printing it here. Okay, and that's the one thing. And after this, one more important thing we'll be doing now. When everybody will start, like I'm a client, the moment I get connected, I'll be getting welcome message from my server saying that, hey, welcome to my application. So I can say socket dot emit what message. And here we'll be saying text, and here we'll be giving welcome to the chat application. Welcome to the chat application. That's how we are creating it up. Okay, which one? Socket.emit. Welcome to the chat application. And that's it. This is how we need to do. So my main file, which is there called public index.html file, will not be having anything just like that. Okay, so let me try to stop. Server is ready. This socket is not defined. Okay. Okay. It is a but obviously saying socket is not defined. Reason because when we say io.on, let me have socket as a parameter. The server is ready. Now the moment I restart, we can see connected to the server. You can see the message is coming up because we have a three instances that are open. Okay, let me close one. You can see this message called connected to the server is coming up automatically. Are you clear, everyone? Everybody, are you all clear? Let me stop this again. And notespaceserver.js, welcome is ready, and localhost. You can see now, connected to what? To the chat server.
Yeah.
Getting it, everyone? So if I want to send a message, what I'll be doing now, just copy this message. And send it to the others. You can see now the message is sent. If open up another one. Connected. Okay. So, but they are not receiving the message. They're not receiving the message because in JS, I write to write a logic. We say like, hey, if the message appears, okay, because I'm sending the message, but I'm not catching it up in an index.html file. So what I'll be doing here in my app.js. Okay. After this, I'll be saying socket.onWait.onMessage. Okay, function message, and here we have to put what? Okay, here we have to just use and we'll be writing. Message.txt, that is very important. And now once it is ready, you see like I received a message from the server, welcome to the chat application. Let me try to, you know, clear everything. Okay, both of them, I clear it up and let start my application from scratch. You can see user is connected via socket and see here if I refresh, you see I receive the welcome message from my server. Yes, I receive the welcome message to my server. And if I pass any message back, say I'm sending a message from client to the server, okay, and the server will receive a message. Can you see this now? Welcome to the chat application or whatever. And here it will be further broadcasting it to him. Okay, so that's how you are able to make it to the other clients to understand like how the communication is going to take place. Are you clear, everyone? We have to just use the same message the way we are trying to say socket.emit. If you want, let's say once again socket.emit. First parameter will be what? Message. And since welcome to the chat application, I say okay, so the server will be receiving a message and broadcast it further. You can see now it is saying hey WhatsApp. Okay, and that's what the server is actually doing this. Okay, so we are saying socket.io message, whatever message is received, it will be further broadcasting it to the others. Everyone, are you all clear? So please do that and let me know by typing done in the chat window, please. So, Ravindra Kaliappan, are you able to broadcast a message from one browser to another browser? It's like that. You have to send a message like this, socket.emit message, something like that. And immediately you can see the message will be appeared into the next one. So once again, we'll be sending the message, it will be received here. So this is how the communication is. Could you please check and confirm? Thanks, Kaliappan and Navendra. What about others? Kindly confirm. I request everybody kindly confirm once you guys are ready and working. So now I'll be basically going and create a new form here. So here in my code, when I talk about index, I'll be creating a form here now. Okay. So what are we doing now here? Let me go back and create a new form here. So I'm writing this form. So within this form, I need to have a bunch of text box with me. Okay. Input type equal to text. I need to have some name also. Just a name, you can give anything in fact if you want. And we can have a one button. Okay, we can say send message, and the form which I'm taking it, I'm taking call ID equal to my form. So that's how we are defining it. And now in my app.js, I'll be picking up, okay, the one to which I need to receive the form. But you need to also remember, I want to display the data also where into the form. Okay, so in my index.html file, I would like to display the message. So here we have a call form. We will be using one div. So within this div, I'm saying div. Data, that's it. Okay, and the data will be displayed here. Okay, everyone. So in my app.js, what I'll be writing it, let's try to understand. Okay, so the code may be a little lengthy, but it will be more meaningful for us. So we are using the socket.io message.text. Okay, here I'll be displaying this message, whichever is received from the backend. So I'm using jQuery. Okay. jQuery, we're using it. Okay, and here using dot data. Okay, dot append, and what I'll be appending is the data, what I'm receiving it. So I'm using this paragraph tag, okay, and I'm using this plus message dot text. Like this. Okay, so that's how we are doing this now. So next time, if I refresh, you see now, I have received the message called welcome to the chat application here. And the same message, I'll be getting it here. So in case if I send any message back from here, okay. So you can see this message, thanks, is appearing it here. Okay, so I'm receiving the message. But that's not all. I also want to send a message through the form. So here, what I'll be doing is, I'll be using this property called, just a variable name equal to jQuery. And here, the ID of the form is called my form. Let's check. It is my form only. Yeah, I have a call my form. Okay, so that's it. And here I'll be using this option called dollar form. Okay, so dot on. We have to basically have the event. So we are using on submit. That means when the form is submitted. So we're using when the form is submitted. Okay, then we'll be using one function with event as a parameter. And here we are saying event dot prevent. Why we are using this? So that I do not refresh the form. Otherwise, what would happen if I do not say event dot prevent default? My page will get refreshed. So to prevent this, we are using this prevent default here. And after that, I'll be creating var dollar message equal to dollar form dot what find. So we have to basically take the input. So we are saying input name equal to message. Okay, message socket dot emit message. If the message is received, text dollar message dot val. Okay, we'll be picking up that value. And after that, I need to keep my text box blank because when the user is entered. So we are saying dollar message dot val, and left it as a blank. Okay. Now let's check. Okay. So now let's say welcome. I just refresh it. Let me restart my server here first. Sorry. Let's restart it. Okay, so basically we have a call button which we are using it right in index.html file. The form I say to my form button. We can use type equal to submit. Okay, so like that we are using it, and here using this event dot prevent the is perfect to event to get published, and let's see this now again. Let's send some message now. So you should see the messages coming up. Okay, so that's how it is you are using it now. So can you please check and confirm if you're able to perform and receive all the messages. Somewhere. Oh, there's some problem. Go ahead and make it happen and let me know once you're ready, please. That's a HTML page too. Afternoon, everybody, once we're ready. Please confirm if the code is working fine. Ali, Ramendra, any update? Dali, any update? Ravindra, Akansha, Tanisha, kindly confirm if it is working fine for all. I'm putting this code inside a chat window. Please confirm if it is working fine for all. Everybody, is my voice audible to all? Kalyapan, it should appear on the same location. Okay, it should appear here in your index.html file. It should appear here. Okay, so check and confirm. So if there is any small fix, kindly do that. It should appear here. I know there's a small fix which I left to you. Kindly make it and let us know. Ali, may I know about what's the status about the code right now? Brenali, if my voice is audible to you, Tanisha, Aliyappan, Ravindra, Akansha, if my voice is audible to all of you, could you please tell me what is the status of your system, of your code? You know, guys, why it is not working? Because there's a very simple mistake. I was expecting that you fix it up. Look, guys, here in my index.html file, if you watch it, everybody, what is an ID here? Come on, it is an ID or not? Akansha Kaliyappan. What is the attribute? It's called ID. So to get the ID, you should use hashtag or not? Come on, you should use hash or not? So use hash and you can see your program is working. Because whenever you try to get this ID, you always use hash or not. To get the class, you use a dot. Just check and confirm if it is working. Let me know if it has started working for all. Please confirm everybody if it is working fine for all. Please confirm everybody if it is working fine for all. Okay, great. So it seems like it is working fine for all. Okay. So guys, I'm sure like that's it. We understood now what we are doing it. And remember one thing, Monday, we'll be working with connecting our Node.js with our Angular application. Okay, everybody. So Monday, we'll be working with what? Angular connectivity with a node. So whatever the REST APIs we have developed in our Express, we'll be connecting with our front-end Angular. Okay, everyone. So guys, then thank you very much. Okay, for joining. So that's it, what we have it for today. We'll see you back on Monday. Till the time, have a nice and great weekend to all of you. Take care, stay safe, and we'll be seeing you back on Monday. Okay, thank you. Thank you, everyone.